Okay, this time let's talk about human development. Human development is basically the pattern of movement or change that begins at conception or birth and continues through the lifespan. So it includes growth and decline, and it can be positive or negative. So there are two major principles of human development. The first one is that development is relatively orderly, which means there is pattern. Now, there are two patterns that are part of the development. The first one is proximodestal pattern, which means that the development proceeds or comes from the center of the body outward. And the other type of development is the cephalocaudal pattern, which starts from the head downward. Okay, now while the pattern of development is likely to be similar, the outcome of these developmental processes and the rate of development, they are likely to vary among individuals, meaning each person develops differently. Okay, now the second is that development takes place gradually. We have to remember that development is the process that is as complex as it is, because it is the product of three or more processes, the biological, the cognitive, the social, and emotional processes. So it is not a one-time big time development. It's a gradual process. Okay, so from there we have different approaches to human development. The first one is the traditional perspective. Okay, from a traditional perspective, they think that, okay, those people who believe in the traditional perspective, they think that individuals will show extensive change from birth to adolescence, and then it would decline, or there would be little or no change at all in adulthood, and then, yeah, decline in late old age. So most of the development happens in the early stages, okay, of human development. While the lifespan approach, for these people, they believe that even in adulthood, development change can take place as it does during childhood. So there is no change in speed of development. So based on these things, we do have this characteristics of lifespan perspective. What are these? According to lifespan perspective, development is lifelong. It does not end in adulthood. There's no developmental stage that dominates the development. Okay. Second one is that development is multidimensional. In this case, development consists of biological, cognitive, and socio-emotional dimensions. Well, it was discussed in previously. Development is plastic. Okay. What does it mean? It means that it is possible throughout the lifespan. Okay. And the next one, it is contextual. If individuals are changing beings in a changing world, so the change depends on the changing world. Okay. The next one, development involves growth, maintenance, and regulation. So these are the three goals of human development, actually. And the goals of individuals vary among developmental stages. Okay, so let's proceed to the principles of child development and learning that inform practice. Okay, now we have here. All areas of development and learning are important. So, learning and development follow sequences. Okay, and development and learning process, it proceeds at varying rate. So development and learning results from an interaction of maturation and experience. So each experience have profound effect on development and learning of a person. In this case, development proceeds toward greater complexity, self-regulation, and symbiotic or representational capacities. Also, accordingly, children develop best when they have secure relationship. So it's important for the children to be able to have stable relationship within the family and the environment they are in. Development and learning occur in and are influenced by multiple social and cultural contexts. Okay, so the next one, children learn in a variety of ways. So play is an important vehicle for development, developing self-regulation, and promoting language, cognition, and social competence here. Development and learning advance when children are challenged. Yes, children's experiences shape their motivation and approaches to learning. So, these are the principles of child development and learning practice. I think that's all for today. Some other things to follow next.